heart. But I want to tell you that God loves you and you are blessed in the name of Jesus. The fact that you are watching, you are connected in the name of Jesus. You are blessed in the name of Jesus. We are just taking from what happened yesterday. We are taking from yesterday for today. Yesterday we were talking about breaking the handcuffs, the cut, the bondage, and the cage. So today is part two video from yesterday. And everybody that is connecting to me, I'm getting so much emails, so much loves. People are praying for me. I thank you for the one that prayed for me. And thank you for the one that I'm praying for too. I love you guys. I thank you for the support. Because it's not about me. Like I always say, it's about only Jesus. Hallelujah. Speak to me, oh Lord. My soul is ready for you. Speak to me, oh Lord. Speak to me. Speak to me. Speak to me, oh Lord. My heart is ready for you. Speak to me, oh Lord. Speak to me. Speak to me. Just like you spoke to Moses and you spoke to Elijah. Jesus, you spoke to Elijah. You spoke to Moses. Lord, speak with me, Lord. Speak with me, Jesus. Jesus, you spoke to Elijah, you spoke to Moses. Lord, speak to me, Jesus. Lord, speak to me, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I know some of people that are always telling me to put my phone down, but since I'm doing live, I'm gonna hold my phone. I'm gonna be looking at it from time to time so I can communicate with you. Today we're gonna continue about the handcuffs. About the handcuffs. What's going on in your life? Yesterday, just to run down, you were saying, how do you know when you are caged? How do you know when you are going through hell? How do you know when you are in bondage, you are in the box? How do you know? I gave some few points yesterday evening. Today, we're going to continue our part two video. And our part two video, we were on number 8. That was the prayer point number 8. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Speak to me, oh Lord. Jesus, bless everybody that has been sending me messages and pray for me in the name of Jesus. Bless for everybody that is praying for me. I receive it in the name of Jesus. Bless you. Bless you, Irene. Thank you for sending me message. I proclaim and declare that you are blessed with your family in the name of Jesus. I got your inbox and I'm loved and I'm thankful that you are following me. Now I bless you. I decrease every demonic of chains in your life in the name of Jesus. I increase every promotion, every healthy, hell, every worthy, everything that is good, because the Bible says Jesus did not come to steal but to build. He's building your life. He's promoting your life in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Speak to me, Lord. Speak to me, Jesus. Speak to me, Father. Speak to me, Jesus. Speak to me, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. doing something that you're not supposed to do. I rebuke it in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. I'm looking at the prayer points because when I got that revelation for praying for you guys to break the chain, this is what you do. You stand and you proclaim and declare what belongs to you. You don't let the devil take over. Our first prayer is to break every laziness. Everything that is trying to hold you back from your destiny. Everything. Sometimes people have issues. People have issues. They may not want to do something. Let's say, for example, it means that when you are doing something that you are not supposed to be doing, you are leaving everything that you're not supposed to be doing. The meaning that you are leaving everything that is important in your life that you're supposed to be doing, but you are just doing something that is not important. That distraction in your life, that laziness, that you're like, oh my God, I know I wanted to go to Walmart and get something to eat. Or I wanted to go to grocery store to get something so I can cook for my husband or wife. And then somehow you forget. Somehow you are doing something else. You get to be so distracted. And you end up not going to church. You end up not going to the grocery store. You end up not going doing anything because you are being lazy. That's the spirit of distraction, of holding you back from your destiny. Let me tell you one thing. If you are like me, I put daily to-do list. When you have daily to-do list, you put today I'm going to do this, tomorrow I'm going to do this. And then I run out of 10 of your to-do list and you do none of them. Or you just do one and you didn't finish what you're supposed to do in a day. I rebuke that demonic of laziness. That demonic of laziness. That demonic of snail that is holding you back. We destroy it in the mighty name of Jesus. The reason why we are just connected today, we went from without me explaining, and just went from like the video starting and we started with the prayers, because this is the video number 2. This is to continue from yesterday. For the people who just are connected to me, I love you guys. But today we are talking about this video number 2. The power to pray for the power to break all the spirits of bondage. A spirit of handcuffs. The spirit of cage. That you've been in a box and you cannot flow. You cannot fly. You cannot have wings to fly. That's a spirit of bondage. That's a spirit of cage. And today we have to break it. All the family generation. The curse on your family. I'm telling you one thing. That can hold you. Can follow you in all your life. But I'm here to tell you that Jesus exchanged his life for you. So that you can be blessed. And you know, if you choose him, if you choose him, if you say, I'm going to stand with her right now so we can break this problem, we can break this delay, we can break the spirit of a spider. You know how spider can, like, the spirit of spider that is going to hold you so that when you don't have to move, that when you don't have to be released, you are released in the name of Jesus. Failure is not your portion in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. When you always find difficult to love a man or to be with a man, let me tell you one thing. God is the best man to love. Starting today, you do not have to worry about that. All you need to worry about is the delay in your life. Because God is here to love you. God is here to bless you. The Bible says, seek the kingdom of God and everything else shall be added unto you. I'm telling you, if you seek in the kingdom of God, you will not have no problem. I declare and proclaim love and kindness in the mighty name of Jesus in your life. I proclaim love and kindness in the name of Jesus. You will love and you will love and you will love and you will love and you will love again, because you are a child of God and nothing will hold you back. I destroy every distraction, every fear of unkindness in the name of Jesus. Choose to love. Choose to love. Refuse jealousy. Refuse this distraction. Refuse dislike. I destroy it in the mighty name of Jesus. The chains are broken in the name of Jesus. The handcuffs are released in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Number 10 is when somebody give you a good job and you mess it up. Did you ever have those people who move from job to job when they don't have no money but the job is not working? That's another point of showing you that you are in bondage. Now, let me tell you something. I'm not saying that staying in your job for a long time is a good thing too. But if you are living from paycheck to paycheck, if you are living in your life that you've never been so much, if you have a heart deepest desire and your life is not moving, let me tell you one thing, that's a bondage. We have to break it. We break it. This is a spirit of chaos. It's a spirit of distraction. It's a spirit of chaos. That's a good word. Chaos. You are careless. You cannot keep something good. Everything that you have is broken. Every relationship you have is broken. Every life you ever done is never successful. It's because it's a spirit of chaos. Now you have to destroy that spirit of chaos. We destroy every spirit of chaos. We destroy, we arrest it. We disconnect it in the name of Jesus. You spirit of chaos, you spirit of distraction, you are arrested in the name of Jesus. We blind you in the name of Jesus. When something is blinded, they don't see unless they have the Spirit of God to hear. But let me tell you one thing. Now you can blind it. You can destroy it in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. When you keep jumping from church to church, from pastor to a pastor, the Bible says when Jesus was unwell and then he was tired, he was sitting down and he saw the lady who was getting water. And Jesus asked the lady, "Can I have some water to drink?" Hallelujah. The lady didn't know that God, she was talking to the King of Kings. She was talking to the bread of life. But I'm telling you now, you do not have to change from a pastor to a pastor, or neither from church to church, because God has given you the water of life. And God and Jesus answered the lady. I'm making it short because on my new video, my other video, I explained the story. So if you want to go and watch it, you have to go watch the certified, purified video. You get the voice. When God was saying, Jesus told the lady that, don't worry, you don't have to go pray to the mountain, or you don't have to go to Jerusalem, or you don't have to go through the prophet for you to be saved, because I myself, I bring, and it's time now to connect to Jesus Christ. And I'm telling you one thing, you do not have to change from church to church, because wherever you go, we are human beings, there's always people that are going to trap you, they're going to catch you, they're going to cage you, just like the way Jeremiah from 25 to 26, it was saying that there will be people among you, the wicked people that they trap you to destroy you, to destroy your situation, to destroy your life. Let me tell you one thing. I do not have a problem with those people. I have a problem with the devil that is telling them in the ears that to destroy the other person. Because nobody's your enemy. It's only devil is your enemy. And God is here to save you. So that's why we have to destroy every spirit of jumping. Oh, hallelujah. A spirit of a butterfly. You move to another one, to another one. Speaking of what, the butterfly, I got the idea because of this jacket. This jacket looks like a butterfly. You move from a one to another church. And you move from pastor to a pastor. And every pastor is putting their hands in your head. Let me tell you one thing. You have to destroy that. Know where you come from. Know who is your father. Because this, the Bible said, I will not fear. I will not be scared. Because who is in me is greater than who is in the world. You have to learn your identity. Learn your agenda. Know your purpose. Then you will not have to worry about what church you go to. Because God has anointed you. God has given you power to fight every old disease. In the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. We destroy the spirit of butterfly in the name of Jesus. The spirit of moving from a place to place in the name of Jesus. You are arrested. You are arrested in the name of Jesus. Pray for your family. Pray for your life. Let me tell you one thing. Faith comes by hearing. And then also faith goes by hearing. Do not let people contact you. Just like the way coronavirus is in the air. It's contagious. It's connecting people. It's a virus. So let me tell you one thing. Let your faith be virus. So that the virus of God can connect other people. So that they can be connected to Christ. So that your family can be contagious. So that your family can praise. Just like Noah with his family. They were saved because Noah believed in God. And they obeyed him and they were protected. Even in a corrupt country. Even like now that virus is taking over. Let me tell you one thing. God is going to create a boat for you. He's going to create a boat and he's going to protect you. So as long as you believe him, you can break those chains in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Semana mi buena. Semana roya mgu. Semana mi buena. I see you guys are watching me. I love you guys for supporting me. Oh, speak to me, oh Lord. Speak in my heart, Jesus. My ears is wide open, Jesus. My family is ready, Jesus. Hallelujah. Speak to me, oh Lord. Speak to me, Lee. Speak to me, Jesus. Speak to me, Father. Speak to me, oh Lord. Oh. Speak to me. Speak to me. Number 12, he says, when you don't even know God's agenda, hallelujah, I was in the spirit. When you don't know God's agenda, hallelujah, do you know God's agenda? Do you know who you are? Do you know who stands before you? The Bible says, do not be discouraged, so because I stand before you. I will not leave you nor forsake you. This was the song from the day before yesterday. When I sing that God will never leave you nor forsake you. Let me tell you one thing. If you are courage, if you are bold, if you are confident in the Jesus, if you are confident in his blood, that he exchanges life for you, you don't have to worry. I do not worry. I lived in LA for 8 years. I know one day I suffered because God had me. It doesn't matter what the devil was trying. God was already chosen me. Let me tell you one thing. I heard this from the very, very wise man. Says, there's a difference between the pastor who is called and the pastor who is not called. Are you the one that ready to hear? Are you ready to hear the voice of God calling you that you are my child and you going to be the watchman? Are you ready to be a gate man? I know a lot of people hate to be a gate man because they feel like the gate man is a very poor job. But I'm okay to be a gate man because I want to be the one that opened the soul. I want to be the one that opened the door for the people to enter. I want to be a blessing. I want to be a soul winner. Are you ready? You have to break those chains that's holding you from your land. Let me tell you one thing. Moses was sent to Egypt to get these people so that they can go to their promised land. God has promised you a land. God has promised you to be a mother of nation, to be a father of nation. Are you ready to receive it? Let me tell you one thing. If somebody could have told me that I was a mother of nation, I would have never even accepted it. But when God prepares something for you, it's yours and nobody can take it. You can be like Job. You can be suffering right now. You can be lost everything. You may not have everything. You may lose everything. But let me tell you one thing. It's only God that gives life. Devil does not give life. Unless you open the door for the devil, then it's on you. But I'm standing here as a great man. I'm standing here as a watchman to tell you that God says, if you choose life over death, you are promised eternal life. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. We're going to read the book of Ezekiel 34:26-28. We're going to read this. It's very important to me because God is cutting all the details down. It's giving you the points for you to understand. Hear me out. It says, I will bless them and let them live around the hill. Hallelujah. I don't know if you are in Colorado or you live in LA. We have hills. Hallelujah. When you are clamping on the hill, you get so tired. But God says he's gonna bless you. And when you're clamping that hill, you will be blessed. Because you will be only on the top. You will only live all the way up. You will not be the lower. God is a God of champions. God is not a God of failure. That's why I deny the spirit of poverty. Because it's not a good spirit. When you have no money or you have nothing, you tend to hate other people. But when you are blessed, when you are rich in your mind, when you are rich in your soul, when you are rich and healthy, hallelujah, you begin to bring it from inside out and you become better. Listen to this, Ezekiel 34:26-28. It says, I will bless them and I will let them live around my hills. Hallelujah. When you walk with the Jesus Christ, that means you will never fail. That means when he dies, you'll be resurrected with him. Hallelujah. That means you are alive. That means you're going to live eternal. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Father, for your blood, Jesus. Thank you, Father, for your blood. Thank you for exchanging your life for mine, Father, Lord. Thank you, Father, Lord, because I'm blessed. Thank you, Jesus, because your children are blessed. And then the next one, it says that I will cause the rain to come when it's time. This Jesus is saying, God is saying, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, He's telling you right now that when it's time, He's gonna cause the shower to shower. It's called the shower of blessing. I'm not talking about hurricane. He says that when the hurricane comes, He's gonna be your tower. Meaning that when the hurricane comes, you're gonna be under His tower and you're gonna be protected, and no hurricane shall take you, no tornado shall take you. But then He says in Ezekiel 34:26-28, He says that He's gonna shower you blessing. He says that He's gonna shower you blessing. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And to those when the times come, and I will shower them with blessing. He says He's gonna shower rains with blessing. Hallelujah. And 27 says, and also the tree in the countryside will give their fruits, and the sheep will be safe on the other land. Hallelujah. Just like the way God told Noah that to build the hut so that He can protect every bird of each kind, man and female, and its family. God is saying that your sheep will be stable. Your sheep will not be shaken by wave. Your sheep will not be shaken by wind. God is also saying that He will send a shower to bless your generation, and the trees on your countryside will bear fruit. Let me tell you one thing. God is kind. Is a fruit of kindness. He's a fruit of blessing and faithfulness, of loving. He's a fruit of wisdom. So God is saying that He's gonna shower the rain so that you can have those trees on your countryside to shower with blessing. Hallelujah. I'm still reading 27. And then it says that, then they will know that I am the Lord. And when I break the bars of their captivities and the sun from the power of those who have made them. Hallelujah, slave. So whatever He has made you slave, God is promising you that He's gonna break it. He's gonna break it. He's gonna break the chain. Hallelujah, Jesus, thank you for your message. The Ezekiel 34:27, He's saying that He's gonna shower, and while showering showering the blessing, the rain of blessing, He's gonna bless you. Why He's blessing you? Your sheep will be stable. No wind will take over your sheep. Hallelujah. Whatever trouble is troubling you right now, God is telling you that He's gonna break every situation. He's gonna free you. Hallelujah. Jesus, thank you, Jesus. He says that He's gonna break all the addiction. He's gonna break all the cage. He's breaking. He's breaking the foundation of the cage that is tormenting in your life. He's breaking it. He's breaking it in the name of Jesus. Then 28 says, they will not be led or possessed by nation against them. The wild animals will not eat them, but they will live safely, and no one will make them afraid. God is saying that He will protect you. That God is saying that He's waiting for you to speak. He's just waiting for you to speak. And then if you ask, He will protect you. He will break the chain. This is the moment. Let's break the chains in the name of Jesus. We break every chain in the name of Jesus. We break every bondage. We break every handcuffs in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Semana mi buena. God bless everyone. As we finish to pray, I pray that everybody's connected in the name of Jesus. I pray that everybody's connected in the mighty name of Jesus. You are blessed in the name of Jesus. You are blessed in the name of Jesus. Man, thank you for everybody that followed me. Thank you for everybody that showed me love. I appreciate you, God, because it's not about me. It's only about you, Jesus. It's only about you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. God bless you guys. We're gonna continue tomorrow for part 3. I hope you guys were blessed. I pray for everybody that is watching me right now. You are blessed in the name of Jesus. Failure is not your portion in the name of Jesus. You are blessed in the mighty name of Jesus. If God can redeem my life, if God can restore and give me a new name, then you are redeemed. You are blessed in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Connected today, Father, as it is our day number 2 to break every chain, I'm delivering in the name of Jesus. I destroy every unfinished business in my life. Every unfinished business is arrested in the name of Jesus. I destroy every error in your life that is trying to torment you in the name of Jesus. Don't forget to share on PMP Ministry on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter, and YouTube. You are blessed in the name of Jesus. You are loved. I'm so filled with love and thanks for everybody that's been commenting, everybody that's been connecting, and everybody that is sending me. I ring you are blessed in the name of Jesus. Your family is blessed in the name of Jesus. Because God has used me as an ambassador, I stand, Father Lord, for PMP Ministry, and I say thank you, Jesus, for loving your praises. And over over 2,000 people that are following us, God, may you connect them, may you bless them in the name of Jesus.